When you do a screen recording on iOS and you have VoiceOver running, the screen reader output is recorded as part of the video.
VoiceOver on. Calendar. Monday the 16th of June. Double tap. Camera. Double photos. Notes. Double tap to open.
However, on Android, if you try the same approach, TalkBack audio is not recorded. So you end up with a lovely video that shows TalkBack's focus indicator and the text output at the bottom of the screen if you've enabled it, but no actual sound. If you search online for a solution, you'll likely come across many blog posts and results that claim that all you need to do is use a different screen recorder. But that's a lie. Those apps don't record TalkBack output either, and I've wasted far too much time trying them out. Now, a cheap solution is to make sure TalkBack's volume is sufficiently loud, and then make sure that when you do a screen recording, set it to capture the phone's microphone. But the result won't be great. It will include any ambient sounds, noise from handling the phone, and so on. Here's an exaggerated example.
TalkBack on. Home. Double tap and hold the long press. Monday, this mostly cloudy, 20 degrees Celsius. Surfshark.
If you want a cleaner result, your best bet is to record to a separate device. One solution that's relatively hassle-free and works quite well is a free program called scrcpy. Make sure you turn on developer options on your Android device and enable USB debugging. Now you can connect your Android device via USB and have it mirrored on your computer. And crucially, audio output from the device is also sent to your machine. Now make the screen copy window as big as you can and then use a screen recorder. On Windows, you can simply use the built-in snipping tool's video recording option, Windows Shift R. Make sure you set it to record system audio and mute the system's microphone. Then try and crop in on the mirrored Android output and record it.
TalkBack on. Home. Letter Glove. Friday the 3rd. Mostly cloudy 20. Surfshark. Files. Camera. Play Store. Gmail. Photos. YouTube.
This works great, but the one snag is if we look at the video that we recorded, the resolution of the video is limited to the resolution of the computer screen. That's probably good enough for most basic use cases, like adding a screen recording to a bug report. But if you want the highest possible quality, and who doesn't, there's a more time-consuming option, a hybrid approach. You do a screen recording on the Android device itself to get the highest possible video quality, but at the same time, you do a screen copy recording on your computer. Then, once you've got the two files, you can use a video editing software. In this case, I'm using Camtasia. And you combine the two, the video recorded on the device and the audio recorded on the computer. In your editing software, make sure that the video project is set to use the resolution of the video that you recorded on the device. Sync up the video and the audio. And after exporting, if we look at the end result, we see that the video itself now has the full device resolution and it contains the clean TalkBack audio output that we recorded.